This video will demonstrate NetVisn's unique data lineage processing and how it provides a complete view of model item and database item dependencies in Cognos. To help understand lineage, let's take a look at a simple example. In Report Studio, an item is placed on the report which references the folders, customers, company name, query item, and framework manager at the presentation level. That item in turn references the DBO customers company name query item and another query subject at the data layer in the model. The query subject is sourced from the SQL statement. From information in the model, it is possible to determine the Cognos data source along with the database table and column which is being used for this query item. To generate lineage for a report, NetVisn reads the specifications for both the report and the published package model from the content store. These are then parsed to determine all the calculations and model references that are required to successfully run the report. Let's take a look at a simple report in NetVisn to see how this lineage is documented. From the NetVisn homepage, we'll navigate to the lineage example report. On the left are links to various sections of the report's documentation. There are several sections related to lineage that we will look at. These sections are very useful for report developers, as they will be able to verify that the correct database tables and columns are being used in the report, and they can also view calculations which are referenced in the Framework Manager model. Let's start with the specification section. This section shows the actual specification that was created in a studio, in this case Report Studio, but this is also true for Query and Analysis Studios. NetVisn converts the data section of the specification XML into HTML so that you can easily see all the queries, model references, calculations, and so forth which are used in the report. The next section we'll look at is lineage. This is where the complete lineage of every data item on the report is documented. Customer name is a simple example. Sequence number shows the depth of lineage. A sequence of 0 shows the expression on the report, in this case a reference to the model item. At sequence 1, we see the expression for that model item, which is another reference in the model. The lowest depth is the reference to the Cognos data source and the database table and column that is used. The order status data item is a slightly more complex example. In this case, the item references a model item, which is a calculation that includes two model items from the data layer, ship date and required date. At the lowest depth, the calculation is displayed using the actual data items. Calculations can obviously get much more complicated, but this should give you an idea how lineage processing works. Seeing calculations of business rules in this way is very useful for report authors who usually do not have access to the Framework Manager model where these calculations are defined. During lineage processing, additional information is collected, which is displayed in the next two sections. The model usage section lists all of the model dependencies which are required to run this report. It contains both the model item references on the report and those that are used in the lineage to get the data items. Database usage contains all of the data items required by the report, including data sources, tables, and columns. All of the links in the model and database usage sections will take you right to the model documentation for that object. For example, clicking on company name will navigate to the documentation of the model reference. I'll use the left menu to go to the customer's query subject definition. Here we can see the SQL query, which is the source for this query subject. The query subject also happens to contain data security, defined where filters are applied to the SQL query based upon a user's security. This is an example of the depth of detail which is documented by NetVisn. All the model and database references we've just seen are stored in the NetVisn database for all reports. Using NetVisn's analysis features, we can easily locate model item and database usage across all objects in the content store. Let's see how that's done by going back to the example report. In the model usage section, the green arrow is a shortcut to the model item dependency analysis. I'll click on the company name model data item. Each analysis contains filters to locate specific data and output options to control how the results look. In this case, we want to find reports which use a model reference DBO customer's company name from the BI reporting package. References will be searched that are anywhere in the lineage, that are on report query or analysis objects, and anywhere in the public content. Detail will be added to the results and will include a specification date. Clicking OK runs the analysis. In the results, we can see all of the public reports which depend upon the selected model item. This is very useful if you will be changing this item in Framework Manager, as it is allowing you to determine all the reports which will be impacted. Next, we will run a similar type of analysis, only this one locates reports which have dependencies on database tables and columns. From the Create Analysis page, the Database Dependency option is selected. In the analysis form, the list of databases used by the reports or models in the content store is populated by clicking the plus icon. We will choose the Northwind data source and then populate the tables list using the customers table. A column name could be selected, but in this case, I want the analysis to find the dependencies for all columns in the customers table. After including detail in the output and grouping by column, we can now run the report. In the results, we can see all the reports which use the customers table grouped by column name. Using the left menu, we can see those reports which use the company name column. Many customers use this analysis to determine which reports and models would be impacted when a change to the reporting database is being considered. Let's recap the various ways that lineage and data dependency features in NetVisn can help you be more productive and in control of your Cognos environment. NetVisn's unique report and model processing captures all the Framework Manager and database dependencies that are required by your reports. This feature has actually been a part of NetVisn since the release of Cognos ReportNet. This information is invaluable to Cognos report authors, as they can immediately determine if the correct tables and columns are being used in the reporting database. This also allows authors to easily view calculations and business rules which are defined in the Framework Manager model. NetVisn documentation of the model is only a click away, where the query subject, relationships, calculations, and anything else in the model can be viewed. Some companies use this feature to save the cost of licensing Framework Manager to report authors. All the model item and database dependencies for all the reports in your content store are stored to the NetVisn database. This allows you to do a number of different analyses, including what Framework Manager model items are actually being used in reports. A common issue we find are models which contain many unused items, which can sometimes hurt performance, but also make it more difficult for report authors. What reports are using a specific model item? Before making a change to the existing Framework Manager model, a NetVisn analysis can show you exactly which reports will be impacted. And as you saw earlier, the same is also true when contemplating a change to the reporting database structure. With the flexibility of the NetVisn analysis features, there are many questions which can be answered about your Cognos environment. Thank you for taking the time to view this video. For more information on other NetVisn features, please visit envision.com/netvisn.